Amen. God bless you. God bless you, beloved. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. What shall I render unto the Lord for his benefit in my life? What shall I render unto the Lord for his benefit in my life? Lord is good to me. All I have is to praise his name. Lord is good to me. All I have is to praise his name. God bless you, my brother. God bless you, my sister. Beloved, I want to introduce to you what I called the greatest key to success. Amen. The presence of this key in your bosom is the expiring date of poverty. The presence of this key in your bosom, beloved, is the expiring date of lack. Every doors are answerable to this key. Doors of breakthroughs don't have choice than to open when this key appears. Doors of success are answerable to this key. Doors of marriage, doors of fruitfulness, doors of healing, doors of employment, doors of ministry all open in their own accord as soon as they notice the presence of this key. Beloved, what is this key? The kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. Let us take our journey to Matthew 6, verse 33. Amen. In Matthew 6, 33, the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. It didn't say seek money first. It didn't say seek marriage. It didn't say seek wealth. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his brother, righteousness. Because in the absence of the brother, you have failed in seeking the kingdom. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. All, not some, all. Beloved, the fact is, you are robbing yourself if you are not seeking the kingdom of God. You are denying yourself of heavenly benefit, if you place material thing above God's kingdom. You are robbing yourself of divine profit and reward if you place your goal above the kingdom of God. You rob yourself of that marital breakthrough you are expecting if you place it above God's kingdom. Beloved, seeking material things before God's kingdom is like you seeking admission into the university without primary education. Amen. Seeking first the kingdom of God is the terminal point of failure, limitation, setback, non-achievement, reproach, mockery, sickness. Amen. That is why you need to hear this song. Hear this song. Who you seek daily really matters a lot. Who you seek daily really matters a lot. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Every other thing shall be added unto you. Every other thing shall be added unto you. Every other thing shall be added unto you. Amen. Amen. Beloved, now, what do you need to lay your hands on this key, the key of the kingdom? What do you need? As usual, the condition is simple. It's repentance. Amen. Repentance. Beloved, are you here and you are yet to know Jesus? You are yet to accept Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. There's no way all these things can be added unto you. Amen. What you urgently need now is to accept Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Do you wish to do that now? Repeat this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for this opportunity to accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Lord, I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that you died for my sake, that you are my personal Lord and my Savior. Lord, I pray that you write my name in the book of life. Forgive me all my trespasses. And from today, help me, never, never to say yes to the tempter, the devil. In Jesus' name. God bless you, beloved. God bless you. From now on, those beautiful, beautiful things, those good, good things you used to pursue, they will now have a U-turn and be able to pursue you. Amen. As you receive this message, beloved, do not waste time. Don't waste time at all. Just share. Share and save a dying friends. Save a dying brothers. Save a dying co-worker. Save a dying partner. Save a dying nation. Save a dying brother. Save a dying sister. Even save a dying parent. And save a dying community. God bless you. I remain your friend, your brother, and your fellow laborer in the vineyard of God, the ambassador of truth. God bless you, beloved. Bye for now.